Hey there! Welcome to Life Noggin. These days, it seems like everyone wants to go into space and colonize new planets. With global threats such as climate change and other factors like a growing world population and Triangle Bob's never-ending appetite, it's probably a good idea to expand humanity's foothold throughout the galaxies. But it had me wondering, rather than rely on another pre-existing planet, could we make a new, habitable planet ourselves? Now, before we begin, it's best to know that we are going to be making a lot of assumptions here, and there will be a world of other factors to consider that we bring up in this video. And even if it is possible, it likely won't happen for a very long time. But for curiosity's sake, let's go exploring. I just hope we end up like the rover, and not the cat. To start off, if we want to be living on it, we should find a good spot in space to put the new planet. We'd want it to be in a habitable zone, meaning the planet should have an orbit the right distance from its star to ensure optimal temperatures, and most importantly, liquid water. Too close of an orbit to its star, and the planet would be a good home for a human torch. Too far away, and the planet would most likely be in a deep freeze. We'd also need the right materials to make the planet. Our Earth has a core made of mostly iron and nickel, then its mantle, which is comprised of mainly silicate rock, with elements like magnesium, aluminum, oxygen, and more. On top is the crust, which has some similar materials, but throws in more things like calcium, sodium, and potassium. If we made our own new planet, we'd probably want it to have similar elements and a similar structure. We'd also want a bunch of water to form some oceans, as most of the Earth's surface is covered in it. Someone should probably start running the faucet now. But even if we get all of the materials, actually creating a new planet like Earth could prove troublesome. It might be a better route to make something more like a giant space station. We've already made the International Space Station and plenty of space vessels, so this could be more in our wheelhouse. It would still require a lot of material and be pretty expensive if we wanted it to be super big, say the size of our moon or a small planet. By comparison, it's been estimated that it would take around $850 quadrillion to build a real-life Death Star. Either route we go, we'd probably also need a lot of food, since there's going to be a bunch of scientists and astronauts out in space working on this project. According to NASA, their average astronaut uses about 0.83 kilograms of food per meal, with 0.12 kilograms of that being packaging material. Excluding the weight of the packaging material, this would mean we'd need roughly 780 kilograms of food just to feed one astronaut out in space for a year, on a 3-meal-a-day diet. One thing that can prove useful for any type of space colonization is having the ability to have a giant magnetic shield to protect our new homes. NASA recently announced that they want to try and deploy a magnetic shield around Mars to make the atmosphere more livable through things like protection from solar winds and radiation. Having something like that at our disposal could help us with a variety of space missions, including terraforming,
which we did a video on.
Putting all this together could be the start of making our own planet one day. In reality, creating a new planet would probably require extremely advanced technology, and there would be tons of other things to consider. But if we could one day do it, what would our new planet be called? Let me know in the comments section below. Have you ever wondered how much space is worth? If so, you should definitely check out this video. One asteroid that passed us in 2015 likely contained 90 million metric tons of these metals, worth up to $5 trillion. Don't forget to hit that bell next to the subscribe button if you haven't already, so you'll be notified whenever we post a new video. As always, my name is Blocko, this has been Life Noggin, don't forget to keep on thinking.